Josh, welcome to Swansea City. How does it feel to be here?
Delighted, you know, obviously coming to a club this size is just exciting. Obviously arriving here today with my agent, like as soon as we got to the gate, I just felt like, yeah, this is what it's about for me, like to, you know, progress and, you know, hopefully help the club move forward.
You know the gaffer from when you were at Burnley. How much influence did he have in your decision to come here?
Yeah, I knew him as obviously a player, and you know, one thing that probably everyone would say in the building is he's just a winner. Like, probably if you go and look at his career, he wins things like he doesn't. He's not about individuals, it's everything's about the team. And you know, I knew I'd get that kind of, you know, kind of vibe off him from, you know, we had a Zoom call because I knew him as a player anyway, and we had a couple exchanges, but that was when I was probably a little boy, and you know, he was a you know, senior pro, and he was probably coming towards the end of his career, and so yeah, I was on the end of a few telling offs and stuff, but no, he's a great guy, and you know, I'm looking forward to working for him.
When did you first hear about the interest from Swansea?
I think it's been about for quite a while, to be honest, but you know, things wasn't moving as quick. I think obviously with like the break and stuff like that, clubs take time, people go away. So for me, I was always, you know, I had different things available, but I don't know, just something about Swansea in a sense of like what I hear about it. Obviously my two ex-teammates, you know, Stephen Kingsley, Barry Mackay, they was like, you love it down there, whatever. And you know, sort of Swansea to me, I see it as a Premier League club, like just the facilities alone. So for me, is a no-brainer.
You're capable of playing as a winger or up front. For Swans fans who may not have seen you play, how would you describe yourself as a player?
You know, I like to make clever runs. I think a lot of my game is about moving and probably annoying people in a sense of, you know, like never letting someone know where I am, kind of thing, and you know, drifting off people, getting myself in the areas where I want to, you know, carry the ball and commit players, so yeah.
Your stats at heart showed you're capable of scoring goals, but you also play a vital part in creating them. Do you get as much enjoyment from creating goals as you do scoring them?
Yeah, of course. I think, to be honest, obviously every player wants to score and assist. I'd be lying if I said I didn't. But I just think seeing the ball go in the back of the net for your team, you know, to win you a game, everybody just wants that, to be honest. And I think when you're at this level, it's not, you know, other levels, no disrespect to Scotland at all, like that league is very tough. And I think, you know, in England or down here, like people kind of think it's easy. I'd love to see a lot of players go up there and do well, because it's not easy. So I think, yeah, like obviously being at this level, it's like, it's a team thing, you know, the next step, we all know what the next step is. So for me, it's a team first. And, you know, if I can get my goals and whatnot, fine, but you know, I'll put the team first.
You made your Football League debut for Shrewsbury Town at the age of 17. Do you think making that step at such a young age stood you in good stead?
Yeah, definitely. I think probably, obviously, the debut was a great memory for, like, you know, myself, my family, that was brilliant. But I think it was more being around first team boys and, you know, sort of learning what to do and what not to do. Obviously, through that stage, I made plenty of mistakes, and you know, it's probably made me the person who I am today. So yeah, I think that held me in good stead. Yeah.
So after joining Burnley in 2015, you embarked on a number of loan spells, including two spells at Lincoln City, where you helped the club gain promotion from the National League. Having experienced a promotion, what would you say are the ingredients of a promotion-winning team?
I just think probably just mentality, in a sense of, you know, not everything's going to be pretty, not everything's going to be perfect, but you know, if you stick to like certain fundamentals of the game and, you know, your team objective, I don't see anything else really going wrong, in a sense of, you know, there's going to be so many games this season where we might turn up and we're not the best, but you know, we grind out a result, and sometimes they're the best ones, and you know, it comes. For a spectator, it's like, he wasn't good today, but at the end of the day, everybody just looks at the result, so.
You scored 22 goals in 89 appearances for Hearts. How much did you enjoy playing there?
Yeah, I love that club. I'll always love that club. I've met some great people there. Had some of my best moments there, like, you know, European football, Scottish Cup finals, you know, playing in front of big crowds. Like, I'll be honest, I'd probably say the attendance up there is probably like better than a lot of Championship clubs, and that's just me being honest. And, you know, especially when you're at like the third biggest club in Scotland, the fans are mental, to be honest, and are very good, get behind the team. And I loved every single minute there. Even, you know, I come there in COVID, and then I went up, well, sorry, we won the Championship, then obviously went into the Prem, got European football. So, like, you know, I've done a lot at that club and had some great moments. And I just think with it being so far for me, I think now this is a lot closer for me to be with my family, and, you know, they'll eventually move down the next few weeks. And yeah.
I know in your social media post when you left Hearts, you mentioned how the club had helped you through injuries and some of the toughest times of your career. You've had to come through some adversity, and it hasn't always been a straightforward pathway for you. What have you learnt from that, and do you think it has given you a sense of perspective on your career?
Yeah, no, of course. Obviously, like, injuries are going to come to every player, whether it's, you know, long-standing or short. They're going to find you at some point, and it's obviously how you react from that. How some boys just get their head down in the gym, and, you know, before you know it, they're back out on the pitch and they're in a better shape than they are, and some boys go the other way. But, you know, for someone like me, I've actually been around, like, I've been to a lot of clubs, so journeyman really. But, you know, I just think that's just a mentality that I haven't ever gave up on myself. So when it comes to, you know, not playing or I'm injured, I'll always be in the fire and I will always come out on top. So, you know, I think that's just like who I am. Like, I like the tests. I like things being hard, because you're a better person once you come through it. So, yeah.
I know you touched on it there, but you experienced a fairly nomadic career before joining Hearts, where you seemed to just settle and really enjoyed your football. Are you hoping to find a similar close-knit environment here?
Yeah, and I think, no disrespect to Hearts, as I said, I loved every minute, but I think this is the next step for me personally. You know, just looking around today and, you know, all the equipment and the facilities that here, I feel like the way I work, I think I'll get the most out of all these things, and, you know, hopefully it reflects on the pitch.
You have experience playing and scoring in the Edinburgh Derby. Are you looking forward to playing in the South Wales Derby this season?
Yeah, you know, I actually seen a video a couple days ago on TikTok, them just getting it every single time. So hopefully we can keep that up this season, but yeah, I'm looking forward to that one.
And finally, what are your hopes personally and as a team for your time at Swansea?
You know, obviously I haven't had a long conversation with a manager at the moment, but I think he'll be very clear on what he wants. And, you know, I don't know anyone in the changing room, but I know that to be at this club, you've got to be a very good player. So I think, you know, we'll probably have more than enough in the changing room. And in terms of me, I just want to come in and, you know, put my stamp on the group, in whether that's on the pitch or off it. Like, I like to see myself as a big personality, in a sense of, you know, I'll have a laugh and joke, but also I'll work hard, and obviously on the pitch, that I want that to come out as well, and hopefully I can help the team move forward.
Well, we wish you all the best, and it's great to have you.
Thank you.